Good morning, students. This video is for the students of class 11th subject economics. In this video, we are going to continue with our chapter number 9, that is revenue, and this is our lecture number 3 for this chapter. In this video, we shall wind up our chapter. So in the previous two lectures, we have read about what do we mean by total revenue, average revenue and marginal revenue. And after that, in lecture number 2, we read what is the relationship between them under perfectly competitive market and imperfect competitive markets, that are monopoly and monopolistic competitive market. Now in this video, we shall read forms different curves in different market. So the first type of market is perfectly competitive market. This is a market in which AR, that is price, is constant and AR is equal to MR. Now, as AR is constant and they both are equal, that is why the curve of AR and MR will be parallel to x-axis. On x-axis, output is given. On y-axis, revenue is given. Now, as price is equal to AR and AR is equal to MR, so in perfectly competitive market, their curve will be parallel to x-axis. And in perfectly competitive market, as TR increases at constant rate, that is MR, okay, so as it increases at constant rate, that is why TR will be a straight 45 degree line, okay. Now, the next type of market is monopoly market. So, revenue curves under monopoly market. Now, in monopoly market, the firm is the individual owner, the firm is the price maker, the firm can set its own price. Now in monopoly market, if a producer wants to increase its demand for the product, that means the producer has to decrease the price of the product. In order to increase the demand, the producer has to decrease the price. If decrease the price, that means AR falls. Okay, so that is why in monopoly market, if AR falls, MR will also fall. Okay, so see, the table would be like this. Output would be 1, 2, 3, 4. As output is increasing, AR would fall, that is 10, 9, 8, 7, suppose. Okay, now as AR falls, MR will also fall, suppose 10, 8, 6, 4. And on the basis of this, you will calculate TR, that would be 10, 18, 24, 28. Now, in such type of market, as price is falling in order to increase the production, as production is increasing, price falls, AR falls and MR will also fall. So, the demand curve under monopoly market would be like this. This is revenue. This is output. Suppose our curve starts from this point. So this is our AR and this is our MR. Okay. Now if you will notice, then MR falls at a faster rate in comparison to AR. That is why MR curve is below AR. Okay. So this is the curve of AR and MR under monopoly market. Now see the monopolistic competitive market. In such market also, AR falls. In order to increase the demand, as AR falls, MR will also fall. Okay, see the table. Output increases from 1, 2, 3, 4. AR decreases by 0.5, that is 10, 9.5, 8, 9, and 8.5. Then TR would be 10, 19, 27, 34. And MR would also fall 10, 9, 8, 7. Now the curve under monopolistic competitive market would be like this. This is revenue. This is output. Now in monopolistic competitive market, our AR and MR curve will also be downward sloping and MR would be below AR. Why? Because MR is falling at a faster rate. Okay, this is the similarity between monopolistic and monopoly market. Now the difference is that in monopolistic competitive market, the curves would be flatter. This is AR and this is MR. So these are the curves under monopolistic competitive market. Now see the firm's revenue curve in different market. Means what is the difference between these revenue curves? Now it is very clear that in perfectly competitive market, the revenue curves are parallel. AR and MR curve are parallel to x-axis. But there is a very slight difference between the revenue curve of monopoly market and monopolistic competitive market. Now, what is the basic difference under monopoly market? Under monopoly market, the demand is less elastic. Okay? And under monopolistic market, the demand is more elastic. Why so? And what does it mean? It means that in response to a given change in price, the change in demand will be relatively more for a monopolistic market in comparison to monopoly market. Why? Because in monopoly market, there are less substitutes. Okay? Whereas in monopolistic market, there are more substitutes of a product. As there are less substitutes in monopoly market, so if the prices of the product will change, the demand will change less. Okay, the change in demand will be less. And as in monopolistic market, there are more substitutes. If there will be a slight change in price of the commodity, then the change in demand would be more. Now see this through the help of the diagram. This is output on x-axis, revenue on y-axis. Okay, suppose this is the price. So, under perfectly competitive market, our AR would be equal to MR. So, this line is DP. That is under perfect competition. Demand curve of a firm under perfect competition. Okay, so demand curve under perfect competition is parallel to revenue curve for a firm under perfect competition would be parallel to x-axis. Now this is DMC. Okay, DMC shows demand curve for monopolistic competition. Okay, monopolistic competition means the demand curve is more elastic, that means more flatter. In the last, I think, 6th chapter, that is price elasticity of demand, we have read that flatter the curve, greater the elasticity. So this curve is more flatter in comparison to this. So for this curve, the elasticity will be more. That means this demand revenue curve is for monopolistic market. And this is DM for monopoly market. Okay, so revenue curve for monopoly market would be less elastic. It means that the elasticity of demand for monopoly market is low because there are no close substitutes of monopoly product in the market. So this is the basic difference between these three curves or these three revenue curves of a firm. Now your homework is you have to learn chapter number 9 and you have to read all back question answers of this chapter.